Hello friends, welcome to the channel. So today we are going to discuss the graphical representation of modified Newton-Raphson method. Okay, so before this we have covered the graphical representation of Newton-Raphson method with clear concept, also the generalized Newton-Raphson method. Okay, so this is also a modified Newton-Raphson method which is used to find the multiple roots of any equation. Okay, so let's have a look. So basically this method is used to get the solution of multiple roots, right? So I have uploaded a video about the what is a root. The prerequisite for this is please watch that video, because it is a knowledgeable video. You will get the clear concept about the kinds of roots, what is simple root, what is multiple root. Okay, so here we will discuss about the multiple roots only. So in the given figure you can see that the point A represents the single root. Similarly, the point B represents the double root, right? The point C represents the single root, and point D represents the triple roots. What does it mean that single, double and triple roots? Means at the single point only we will get one number of root, that means single root. Double root means we will get two number of roots. Okay, like the we have mentioned in the equation P of x. So in that function you can see x minus a is a single root, okay, but x minus b to the power whole square, that represents the double root. That means x equals to b you will get for twice. Similarly, x equals to d you will get for thrice. Okay, so that is what called multiple roots. That means when at a single point you will get two or more than two number of roots, that is called what? Multiple roots. Okay, now what is the difference between single root and double roots? There is a lots of difference in terms of the characteristic if you are going to talk about any system. Okay, so here also we will not go about the characteristic because it will take another time, or I'll upload. So whenever we are going to get the multiple roots with the help of the numerical methods, we get some limitations. What are those limitations? Here, for a function with even multiple roots, okay, even multiple roots means double root or quadruple roots, this kind of thing, the function does not change sign over the interval. Okay, you can see at the point B I have double root. There the curve is not crossing the x-axis. That means the sign of the function will not change. Okay, it will be only positive or negative. So it will be difficult to get the root. Similarly, you can see here that at point B, if we'll draw the tangent to the curve, at that point the tangent of the curve will be parallel to the x-axis. Okay, so the crossing of that tangent line to the x-axis, that will be difficult to find, right? So that's why we are not able to apply the Newton-Raphson method directly, because it is basically depends on the tangent and its crossing line at the x-axis. Okay, that we have covered in the graphical representation of Newton-Raphson method. So here we cannot apply the direct Newton-Raphson method. We cannot have the tangent cross, as well as we cannot have the sign change, right? So that's why what we are going to do, we are going to use the Newton-Raphson method only, but with a modified version. Now what is that modification? We will see. See here, you can see the modified Newton-Raphson method. So the general Newton-Raphson method is what? Xn plus 1 equals to xn minus f of x divided by f dash of x. This is the normal formula for Newton-Raphson method, right? But here we cannot get the value for f dash of x because the tangent is 0, or we can say f dash of x value is 0. Okay, so that for that value, what we are going to do, if f dash of x is 0, that means the complete function will become infinite and we are not getting any finite value or a proper value. So for that, what we are going to do, we are going to take a function g of x which is equal to the ratio of f of x and f dash of x. Okay, and now we are going to have the differentiation of g of x, that is g dash of x. We can see the general differential function I have mentioned. The according to that, the given function is here. Now I am applying
the Newton-Raphson method for g of x function. So the function will be like this, okay, and here I am putting the value of g of x and g dash of x simply. So after putting the value and solving the equation, I am getting this final value for x n plus 1. So this is the modified version of Newton-Raphson method. Here if you will see, if you put the value of f dash of x equals to 0 also, then also the function will be finite, means you will get some value, right? That means there will be no problem if the f dash of x is 0. That means we are having the multiple roots, okay? So this is the modified version of Newton-Raphson method with the graphical interpretation. We can have a complete clarification with the problem solution. So here we have the problem. We have to use the modified Newton-Raphson to evaluate the multiple roots of the given function, okay? So it is very simple. Here you have to just remember the value of the formula for x n plus 1 and put all the values here. So we have been given by f of x, that is x cube minus 5x square plus 7x minus 3. So get the value of f dash of x and f double dash of x, okay? After that, just put all the values in this given function and solve it. You will get your first iteration value, okay? We know that for Newton-Raphson method, we should have a initial approximation of root. So that has been taken as 0, okay? So after putting this all value, we got some value for x1, okay? As you can see here, so x1, the calculation of x1 gives the 11% of error. So that means we are getting some value of error. So we are going to reduce it by taking more number of iterations, okay? So you can see the values in second iteration, third iteration, right? So this is the values for the starting value of x equals to 0. So here you can see in the third iteration, we are getting the value around 1.5 times 0.2, okay, which gives the error of 0.00024, that means 2.4 into 10 to the power minus 4, which is a significant accuracy, okay? So this is the one value, but here we can have multiple roots, right? So for that, I'm going to do the same process, but now with the another initial approximation. And now I have taken the initial approximation as 4. You can see x naught equals to 4 I kept, and I got the values for x1 as 2.636364, okay, where I am getting the error of 12%. So we are going for more number of iterations, and at the fifth iteration, I am getting the closer value to the 3 with the error of 7.7 into 10 to the power minus 5, right? So these are the roots for this given function. What is that? That is x equals to 1 and x equals to 3. So this is the complete procedure for the modified Newton-Raphson method with graphical interpretation. Hope you all get the clear concept. If you have any kind of doubt, or if you have any kind of suggestions or any kind of demand, you can write in the comment box. You are most welcome. Thank you. Thanks for watching.